Let's begin now.
We are live. What's going on, everybody? Mastermind through tough times. We do this every Tuesday at 2:30. So good to see you all again. Today is going to be a good day. It's 4:20. You know, some great things going on.
Waiting around.
Hope you enjoy this show. Before we get started, like, share, and comment. Hey, we have a great drawing. At the end of the show, we're giving away a facial from Margaret Harrison with Mary Kay. I'm going to show you some things. I'm going to show you what you can win here shortly. Before we do that, like, share, and comment so you can be entered into the drawing. Let's jam out, y'all. Hey. It's going to be a good day, y'all. Thanks for joining in. This is Mastermind for Tough Times. Every Tuesday at 2:30. This is what we do. Hey. Come on. We're going to have a good day. Like, share, and comment, guys, so you can be entered into a drawing at the end of the show. I'll show you guys what you can win. All you got to do is just like, share, and comment, guys. Hey. All right, you can win this facial right here, guys. All you got to do is like, share, and comment. Had to pull up a flyer for you. So like, share, and comment, guys. You'll be entered into the drawing for a virtual sampling session. Miss Margaret Harrison from Mary Kay. You are tuned into Mastermind of Tough Times. We do this every Tuesday at 2:30. It's a little shop talk. We talk about a little bit of everything and a little bit of nothing. I got my crew in the back. Michael G. Davis and Margaret Harrison. Hey. It's a feel-good song right here. Just, hey. Save that drama for another day.
We might as well do exactly what the children say. Take the day off, hit the park, and just
hey, that'd be nice.
Roll a few and put up the deuces. And
if we
put the peace, come on. It's time to change our ways so we can save the day for the children's sake and make a better place to play.
Mastermind for Tough Times, guys. Come on, like, share, and comment. We definitely appreciate you tuning in. Go ahead and let everybody know, all your friends, family, your uncle, sister, your brother. Let them know. And we are here live on Facebook. Getting into some good topics today. Topic, the title is the untapped potential of the Dogecoin coin. Dogecoin, however you pronounce it, in video gaming. So we see the future of gaming. That's what we're going to talk about today. Come on. Like, share, and comment, guys. Mastermind for Tough Times. Great drawing at the end of the show. Our sponsor. Hey, I like those snaps. Right down.
You can save that journal for another day. Hey, we're gonna have a good day.
Come on. Put in the comments if you are jamming today. Let's get into our theme song for our show today. Blinding Lights, The Weeknd. Let's get it, guys. The topic of the day is the untapped potential of the Dogecoin in video gaming. Hey, like, share, and comment, guys. Mastermind for Tough Times. Woo. I see you, Margaret. Don't make you want to do that? Do the crossing. This is what we do, guys. We just cut up, have fun on Tuesdays. Tuesday, Mastermind through Tough Times at 2:30. Hey, this is Realtors having fun, showing you another side of us, what we do, you know, besides just sell houses. Even though we love it, guys, we just like to talk, get together, and see how we can, you know, improve our business, connect with clients. All these things are important, guys. Mastermind through Tough Times. Hey, let's jam out. We'll get started here soon, guys. My crew is going to be coming in here shortly. The first thing, you know, that we do is get the show started, trending topics. So we're going to talk about some current topics going on trending in entertainment. We'll be starting here soon, guys. Hey. Mastermind is tough time. We do this every Tuesday at 2:30, guys. Thank you for tuning in. If you haven't already, like, share, and comment. Get that out to all your people. Let them know we are here. Go ahead and show some love in the comment section. Chad, I see you here. Hey. Catching you guys before my flight back home. Have a great show. We appreciate it, Chad. We wish you traveling grace. We hope you get to your destination safely and that you return safely, my friend. Thank you for tuning in and showing us love. Yes. Come on. Hey. Oh, Margaret's chiming in on our current topic today. She said she got to get her some Dogecoin. Oh, yeah. I've been watching it. Haven't found my price point that I would go in it yet. I don't think. We'll see. Mastermind, it's a tough time, guys. I see you all in the building. This is what we do every Tuesday at 2:30. My crew back there is getting out to masses so you guys can join in and have fun with us today. Hey, this right here just makes me want to put on, I don't know, my skates. I think we had a song last week that had me want to put on some skates. I'll get my little, I'll get me a new pair.
What's up, Jesse? Out here gaming, baby.
What's going on, man? Hey. That's my crew, man. Indeed.
What's up, people? Welcome to the Mastermind Through Tough Time. We just real estate professionals out here talking about randomness. You know,
that's
just it. Hey, how we doing? I'm your host, Michael G. Davis, aka Professor X, because peel back that layers, get all them challenges, barriers, all that stuff out of your way. Broker, CEO of Brooks and Davis Real Estate Firm, Realtor, plus business coach. Join, as always, on this beautiful Tuesday at 2:30 with my cohort, the one on the right, Ms. Margaret Harrison.
Yes, that's me. Hey, y'all. I am Margaret Harrison, also known as Mystique, because I will flip on you when it comes to negotiations.
Absolutely. That's how she do. She was our most recent guest on our Real to Life podcast today.
I was.
Did a phenomenal job on the podcast.
Thank you.
And then we got Jam and Jay in the back, keeping y'all on y'all feet. Jay talking about putting on shoes. I mean, putting on skates.
Skates. I'm telling you.
All right, tell the people who you are, Jay.
Yes, indeed. What's going on, guys? It's your keeping real to Jay Joseph, aka X-Ray, getting down to your real estate needs. I see what you can't see. Yes.
Absolutely, absolutely. So for you all, this may be your first time making it onto the Mastermind Through Tough Times. This is something that we come together every Tuesday at 2:30. It's kind of like shop talk, right? When you go get your hair did, or your nails did, or your hair did, any of that stuff. And then while you're waiting, you're chilling, right? You just get to talking about anything that come to mind. So that's all this is. It's just real estate professionals talking about randomness, about what's going on in the world as a way to put our hair back, sit back, and relax. All right. So, Margaret, what you got for them today? What's trending?
Okay, so.
It is 420.
Yes, and it's number one.
It is 420.
Number one. People are celebrating cannabis culture.
Man, they say the cannabis companies want to eliminate some of some of those terms, like the lingo and the verbiage as it relates to that. Maybe they're trying to more formalize their perception as legit. Like,
oh, make it mainstream?
Yeah, like that. Don't take our 420 away.
I think they need to lean into it.
Oh, yeah?
Like make 420 mainstream.
Like Cinco de Mayo.
Yeah, just lean into it. It is what it is.
Cinco de Mayo. Yeah, y'all know what it is. Hey, look, 420 was here before y'all was here. Before it was legalized. We was out here doing 420, baby.
Okay, so this looks like if somebody was have been imbibing on 420. That would scare them.
What? Oh, that is. With all them eyes. Is that like a, is that a tattoo?
I don't know if Jessica can get to it.
Click on the happy 420.
Yes, click on happy 420, Jess.
And let's show the people this craziness out here. They got craziness
it
out here on 420.
Oh, wait a minute.
Too short? Where he been?
Scroll down until you see a lady that has the cannabis.
There it is.
That right there. You just
go back up there.
It.
That lady got all them eyes on her face.
Now, if you would happen to be imbibing today and you saw that, would that really freak you out?
When you was, if you was on that, if you was partaking in that 420 celebration, that'll freak you out. And she got green hair. Let me tell you something.
It's like, it's a problem.
Come on, man. You stay at the house. You can't come to the 420 party.
Yeah, you don't need that narcotic.
Not, you don't need that in your life. Yes. They say it's a gateway drug. That's what they say.
Yes. I don't mess with it.
I disagree.
Amen, Jessica. Amen.
I disagree. And I feel like that's more psychedelic than, not that I, you know, I just feel like that's more of the perception than the cannabis 420. I don't feel like, yeah, you know, and I think that's some of those misconceptions that they're trying to attack.
I agree with you, Jess. Anything that comes from nature, I feel like it's okay.
Yeah, I just had to chime in on that for you guys.
And you know what, Jessica? Thank you for sharing. Thank you for adding.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Dogs come from nature too. They bite you.
They only bite you if it's blood in the water. Now, if it ain't no blood in the water, if they don't think you no turtle or no seal or nothing, they're gonna leave you alone.
So that's a lot of variables you have to make sure the shark is okay.
How about we just don't go get in the water with sharks? Like, how about we don't do that?
But that's their area.
How about we don't go get in it? Like, that's what I'm saying.
So don't go to the beach. Don't go.
Don't go in the deep. Sharks need deep water.
All right.
Y'all, you looking at too much Jaws.
All right.
Jaws.
Okay, so that's 420 day. So that's number two, trending Earth Day. I think the topics are related.
So Earth Day and 420 the same day today, this week, this year?
Okay, wait a minute. Well, Earth Day is trending, but Earth Day is the 22nd.
Oh, it's the 22nd. All right. Because so I was like, no, trending. I don't ever recall it being on the same day.
Yeah.
It should be, though. I think Earth Day and 420 day should be on the same day. It's about the Earth.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That may help 420 be more mainstream.
It being on the same day as Earth Day.
Mm-hmm.
Cannabis need to just chill out. You can't be uptight being in the cannabis business. Like, don't do that. Stay where you're at.
So at number three, we have another Apple event.
Of course. Of course. Got to keep everybody entertained with what's going on with Apple.
Apple announces a new iMac.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I haven't had my first. You're a fan of the iMacs, aren't you?
No, I haven't had an iMac. I have an iPad.
But you, when you replace your computer, you're going to get an iMac problem?
I don't know.
Really?
I don't know.
But you are Apple. That's what you do. That's how you roll. You Apple.
I don't know. You sure put me in the box.
I'm just telling you. I'm telling you what I see.
I have a Toshiba laptop at the moment.
And we know how that's working for you.
It's working fine. It'll work. It'll do what it's supposed to do.
It don't.
I'm mainly on my iPad.
Exactly. That's my point.
Well, they have a new one coming out, and it looks
like an iPad.
Yeah.
It looks like the Surface is what it looked like.
Yeah, and the Surface. Who makes like Microsoft? Maybe I'll get a Microsoft.
Apple, y'all can't be biting off of Microsoft. Y'all were the trendsetters.
Ooh, it's $10.99. Well, no, that's the iPad Pro.
Yeah.
So where's the Mac?
Have you seen the commercials of the guy doing the price comparisons and so forth? Of the Surface.
Yeah,
and
that's why I'm thinking maybe I just go get something else.
Hey, look, that Surface is looking pretty nice.
It's always had some clout, like, to be honest with you. It always
I think Apple's
clout.
Snapping back from those commercials.
Yeah, I think they are. They are as well. You know, Apple had the whole, well, you ain't need the PC part no more. You just put it all in the monitor. And that was live at that time. Hmm. But, We didn't went past that.
Well, the colors are nice.
They are. The colors are nice, Jeff. Margaret, I agree with you.
They have some nice
colors. They're putting in this new Pentium processor. They're trying out this new processor in them now that's supposed to rival the core processors that are in the PCs, the Intel. you know, Apple just, they just like, you know what, we ain't gonna do what everybody else doing. Like, why don't they just put an Intel Core processor in the computers? They're like, nah, we're gonna find somebody else that's just as good. Just cause they wanna be Apple.
Or maybe they get a cheaper price with the other people.
But it needs to perform just like the Core. I love me a Core. i5, i7, i3, baby, bring it to me. Bring it to me. All right, what else we got?
Okay. So that was number three. Number four, Ted Nugent.
What'd he do?
Ted Nugent tests positive for coronavirus.
I mean, at this point, who hasn't had coronavirus?
After calling the pandemic a scam.
See, that's why you need to just stop talking.
Okay, so number five, Doge 420.
Uh-oh, Doge 420, baby. So what, Dogecoin is gonna...
Maybe you can buy your cannabis with your Dogecoin.
Maybe that's what we should have. Maybe that's what we should have called today's.
Yeah.
Dogecoin. Use your Dogecoin on 420, baby. Let's go.
So what's behind Dogecoin's wild week?
So it had a 400% rally. I mean, when you're dealing with like pennies and nickels,
mm-hmm.
you know, to go from 8 cents to 40 cents, you're looking at it percentage wise, 400%.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Hey, look.
Whereas Bitcoin, let's see, was 1/100th of that. Okay, so wait a minute.
She's saying I own 1/100th of a Bitcoin, whereas you could own like
4,000 Dogecoin.
Doge? Get your Dogecoin?
Hmm. So which one is better, Bitcoin or Dogecoin?
Well, I mean, it's all crypto. Yeah. It's all cryptocurrency.
It's all imagination.
But Dogecoin is more affordable than crypto at this point. I mean, not crypto, and Bitcoin at this point, I think, because Bitcoin is been out longer.
So this person says fans are driving Dogecoin higher to mark an auspicious day, even while other cryptocurrencies continue to struggle.
Uh-oh. Boy, struggling in his crypto life. Ooh, I'm blinded by the light. Okay.
Is that going to be in our head the rest of the day?
Probably. That's why we picked it. That's why we picked it.
Okay. So number six, Tuesday Motivations is trending. So that's always nice when you're feeling down. You need a little pick me up.
All right. So let's end it with this one, right? Okay. Luther Vandross birthday, baby.
Doom, 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 doom. You don't like my Luther?
I miss it. We love it. I miss Luther, man. Luther was the bomb.
A house is not a house.
It ain't.
And what's the rest of it?
I don't know. But I miss Luther.
In a chair, still a chair.
I think we should listen to, I think for the rest of the day, we should listen to Luther Vandross.
Even when there's no one sitting there.
Yeah. Look at Margaret's melody.
I ain't gonna do it.
Give it to him, Margaret. The people want it. Like, they begging for it. They like, give it
to
us.
I need to warm up.
Mine was the Bad Boys. Bad Boys in town. You know that one?
Oh, yeah. You better not go out tonight.
Yeah, that one. Bad Boys. Like, that's the only part I recall.
And that was your favorite?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I ain't heard it in a while. That's all right. I got my Spotify premium. I go ahead and put that Luther. This is Luther Vandross on today.
He would have been 70 years old.
70 years old, boy.
And Google did a nice thing. They had a little. They call them.
They call them doodles. The Google Doodle.
That's really nice what they did.
You got to press play. Did you press play?
Uh-uh.
So, you know, on the Doodle, you press play and then
it'll
do what it do. Yeah. No, you probably won't do it right there.
It's just a gift.
Like when you Google it and pull the Doodle up in actual Google, then it'll probably showcase.
Oh, nice. Well, Google did it. Oh, and Dion said something about him too. Miss Warren.
She should.
Get it, girl.
She should. Uh-huh. All right, let's go. What are we talking about today?
We're talking about Dogecoin.
Gaming.
And gaming.
Yeah, man. So what you think gaming going to look like in the future? I mean, at some point, boys going to really actually be getting in the games.
Yeah, I'm thinking Tron. I'm thinking, what was that one with Arnold Schwarzenegger?
The last superhero?
No, he was in this like bodysuit running. He was like in the game too. What was that called?
Oh, I know what you're talking about.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay. It wasn't Total Recall, but it was
another. No, I know what you're talking about, because it was like a game show and they had to get out of it.
Yeah.
Who? Or it was when they saying like, I'll buy that for a dollar. Wasn't that like the thing that they would do?
I don't remember.
I don't either, but I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, so it's like those kind of, I'm thinking that, like real world type of stuff.
But those were like tournaments, like gladiators, football, yeah, things right. like that. So I think this is going to be more like, you know, so if you look at like a Call of Duty, like you'll actually be able to get, you got bullets flying all over you, man.
Ooh, and if you get hit. And it hurt when it like hurt for real. If you
man, I would never play a game that does that. That did that.
There's a movie called Ready Player One.
Yeah, where they got in the video games. Yes. They had all the kids there with the little things, and then they playing in the game.
Yeah. So.
That's is. Mm-hmm. But you know what? That's probably what it was, because that's how they would get into the game through those different little portals and stuff, and they would build their little avatars, and they would have to make money and get money. That's probably what it's gonna be like.
There's another show on Amazon Prime called Upload.
I ain't seen that one.
Okay, so this is when people actually pass away. They take their consciousness and upload it.
No.
And they chill it. Yes.
In the game system?
In the
system.
First
of all, how do you take somebody's consciousness?
I don't know they doing it.
It's coming.
You can put it in a robot and you can never die. And like, okay, that's
man, let me rest in peace, Blair.
Well, that's what some people were in the game, well, in this thing, say, hey, you, if you die, you should die. Stop uploading people.
Oh, that's what they were saying in the show?
Yes.
So is it like a series or a movie?
It's a series. Oh, but the bad thing about it is the more money you have when you die, you can get a really good system. Mm. So they have some people just sitting in a white room, just sitting there because they don't have no money to get the finer things to upload just, to like a really
nice saying,
place.
Let me die. You're gonna put me in a white room.
Yeah, and then some people will have a little money so they can buy some minutes, mm-hmm. but when their minutes run out,
then they're in the white room.
Yeah, they're in their white mm-hmm. room. So it's a give and a take.
It just seemed like torture. Like for eternity, you're gonna be in this white room looking at the wall.
Well, if you can accumulate enough of Dogecoin, maybe you can just chill in paradise forever.
Your consciousness can gonna have you on the beach, baby.
Yes.
Forever.
Yes. And it's a real good series because they make it so you can interact with those who are still here.
Oh.
So those people will have to put on a special suit and the goggles.
And then they can go see Grandpa?
Yeah, and they can go see.
In his white room?
Mm-hmm. No, but they have to have money to go put the suit on.
Oh, okay. So that Grandpa probably on the beach.
He's doing good. That's upload. So
would you play a game that if you got hit, it would hurt? Like maybe can you like imagine doing like Mike Tyson punch out and every time glass, you know, you got hit in the mouth, glass jaw or Tyson punched you?
It can't hurt, but maybe if it tickle.
If it tickle.
If they hit you.
You'll be trying to get hit. You'll be trying to get hit.
But it don't need to hurt.
I feel
because that'll defeat the purpose of the game.
Just imagine some of these zombie movies, man. I just can't imagine being inside of a game, bro.
Well, like, there's a Walking Dead game. It's real fun.
Is it really? You played it? So you're a gamer?
See, this is the on the phone game.
Undercover gamer.
No, on the phone, not the serious with the chair and the headphones. No.
And the headset and talking to the other players.
No, this is just on your phone. So, yeah, it's fun. It's like, okay, you got to get all the zombies in between their eyes.
Mm-hmm.
You got to, build up your place around. You fortify mm-hmm. so can't none come in.
Mm-hmm. So you don't get killed.
Yeah, you got. So you don't want to get killed.
So they say, I mean, but you know that that gaming stuff is like a $1 billion business.
Yes, you were telling me something about your son and Minecraft.
Yeah, but some of these up. But I'm talking about like the little competitions. You know, they have like these gaming competitions now.
Okay.
At one point, they was on TV, maybe USA, the USA Network, and they would show the actual gaming competitions.
Oh, like how they do the poker competition?
Yeah, and they'd be in Vegas. Matter of fact, like I think the Mirage just built a stadium to host gaming competitions. I don't know if it was the Mirage or if it was one of the hotels out there just did it.
So there is a future there.
Hey man, it's money to be made, player. Y'all better get y'all gaming up.
I don't think you need to feel it if you get shot.
Well, you said tickle. That's okay.
Yeah, just tickle, but now
pain.
Yeah, you don't even feel
it.
Because people might have heart attacks.
Hey, look, player. Hey, don't touch me. Don't touch me, dog. That's all I'm saying. Don't touch me, dog.
And I was thinking, like, what if you get scared though in the game? Will that just give you a heart attack anyway?
Or you pee your pants.
Yeah, okay. So maybe it shouldn't be so realistic.
Well, that's why people like it.
Because it's realistic.
Because it's so real. Keeping it real.
Keeping it real. That's an Al Sharpton show on SiriusXM.
I wouldn't know that.
You would?
It seems like something that you listen to.
Sharpton.
You need keep to call in. You need to call in next time and say, "Yeah, Sharpton, what you think about the future of gaming?" And see how he responds.
Okay. But see, you have to wait on hold for a long time. He's gonna be like, "Girl, you playing on my phone?"
You blocked.
Sorry, Mr. Sharpton.
All right.
Continue.
So, what topic you got for the people today? Real estate wise.
Our real estate topic for today is our neighborhood amenities
important as it relates to if a person should buy in that area?
Yes.
I think that's why people buy is location, right? When they say location, location, location.
Yes, but what if you have a location that's far out, but you have like some really nice amenities?
Well, you know how COVID is. Man, boys ain't got to go to their office no more. They working from the house.
That's true. So you don't have to work near home.
Yeah,
to
man.
Drive into
they
the
like
office.
Giving them his amenities. They want that boat dock.
The boat docks, the splash pads.
Yeah, they want all that. The clubhouses,
the movie theaters.
Yeah, man, they want the little mascot dog that just roams the neighborhood.
Yeah, those are cute.
Are they?
Yeah, I think one of them name was Sunny or Sunflower.
Yeah, they had their own little doghouse, like a labyrinth doghouse, like mascot. Cute. Hey, man, that boy living better than some other people out in the hood.
Yeah, so ain't nobody gonna call a pound on him. Like, hey, it's a dog roaming.
He belong there.
And they're like, oh, yeah, this is hood.
Yeah, it's where he lives.
Yeah.
Play, I wish they would.
Yeah, he call on you.
Right.
Like,
matter of fact, you leave. How about that?
Yeah, I'm calling on you.
Get you up out of here.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, I think the amenities are here to stay. The amenities are here to stay, especially now that, you know, things are moving away from having a commute. And, you know, traffic has always been the big issue with Houston. But look, there's, you know, the space. The large lots, the land, that's out in the burbs, baby. You got it. Yes. And you know, that's what people want when they have kids.
But the better the amenities, the higher the fees.
HOA fees. Yeah, true enough. But hey, if you don't have such a large gas expense because you're not commuting as much, right? Mm-hmm. Then it probably works. And then the thing is, if you have the amenities in your neighborhood or close to your neighborhood, then it does, you don't have to drive into the city. Like Manville. Like Manville is about to create their town center. Like all of the suburbs having their own town centers now. Like, you know, Katy, and then you got the town center right there off on the west side by I-10 and I-10 and the Belt.
Does Sugar Land
got a town center. Pearland got their town center. Now Manville. Come on, Manville. Okay. Step up to the plate. Get your town center done. Player. Manville. Let's go. And the only reason I know that is because my son, who plays select baseball, has us tribing all over the place. Why don't they have any baseball games inside of the city? Why are the cities everywhere else? It takes me 45 minutes to get there. I digress, though.
Yeah.
I digress.
That's a pain point.
But I guess it's okay. He got a ring this weekend. What? Shout out, Houston Hornets. Let's go, baby. Number one, champions. Champions this weekend in Beaumont, Texas.
We won the ship. We won the ship. We won the ship.
Good. What you know about the ship? You been in athletics?
No. I have cousins and uncles who have kids who are in all these sports things.
On your face, it just looks like it's tiring.
Yeah, and I don't even go. I'm like, y'all, it's too much.
But you love it. It's for the kids.
What
else you going to do?
Tired.
All right.
Let them cheer and play some games.
The future of gaming. Yes. Emo babies. In there. All right, what tip you got for the realtor today?
Okay, so my realtor tip of the day is...
Cold calling. Should we still be doing that?
Yes.
Does it work?
Sometimes. It builds your muscles up, your rejection muscle.
Yeah, man.
And you can start blocking rejection. I don't care. I'm calling you.
Yeah. I heard one guy told me that cold calling is the consequence of not having a database. are not having a network.
It may be true, but cold calling can get you a database.
Yeah,
somewhere to start.
But there are warmer ways to build your database.
I have a funny story.
Oh, Margaret's got a funny story
about a warm way, because my partner and I at the time did not want a cold call because we were scared.
Which is what most people.
We were scared. And you know that thing that you're scared of is the thing that will confront you.
On multiple occasions, absolutely.
So we were saying, okay, well, let's have a warmer introduction. Let's send out a mail out and have the people call us.
Okay.
It's like, hey, you calling me.
Let's go, baby.
I'm not cold calling.
It's a warm lead.
So our first go around, we sent out these really nice flyers.
Okay.
We didn't get anybody called.
Nobody called. Did you spend a lot of money for the flyers?
We did.
Okay.
And
mail out is pretty expensive. I got you.
So we were thinking, what if we handwrite it and the people will feel like, okay, these are real people. Let me call them.
So like handwrite each letter?
Yes.
How many did you mail out?
So that's when we had to get a strategy together. We picked the ones we wanted to send. So it was like 20.
Okay.
So it was like, we can do 20.
20 handwritten letters.
Yes. All right. And then we also came up with another plan to write it real big, to make people really want to call us. So we wrote it real big.
On an 8.5 by 11 sheet?
Yes.
But and you we just folded wrote big it. On it.
Yes.
Okay. Did they call?
Yes, they called.
Okay. That's a good thing.
But the rejection part bit us.
It was
because one man said, what is this? Why are you sending me this Mickey Mouse writing? And you think I'm gonna work with you? I'm not gonna work with you. You sending, and we were like, sir. That was just for you to call us, sir. He's like, I don't care. I'm not doing business with nobody writing like this.
And he just felt like y'all needed to know that.
Yes, and that was our rejection. We was like,
so did y'all just send the mails no more?
We ain't do that no more. We went back to the regular ones and just figured it has to be the numbers.
It's got to be the numbers.
And the consistency.
Got to be the consistency. So did it end up working for you?
We got one person from it.
Yeah.
But
y'all got no more Mickey Mouse writing.
No more Mickey Mouse writing.
Yeah. So, I mean, cold calling, if you built for it, everybody ain't built for it, right? So if you built for it, then I definitely tell you to do it. Like, you can actually outsource it at this point. Like, I outsource my cold calling. I got somebody in Jamaica that called my people. Matter of fact, she's working right now. Shout out Anne Marie.
Do she sound Jamaican?
I don't know.
And she's
I
like,
never talked to her on the phone.
Yeah, man.
Well, she be getting these appointments. She be getting these appointments though. Whatever.
It's 420, man.
Whatever.
420, man.
Whatever she sound like, she be getting it done.
Welcome to Jamaica.
It's, you know, you probably pissing off a lot of Jamaican people right now.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, man.
But y'all can make fun of my accent. I know I got one.
Yeah, that's all right. You're gonna be getting a phone call from Kamala. Kamala's gonna call you. Like, you joking about my hair?
But
no,
she don't have an accent. She's not in there. I called the meeting to order mine.
Because she's partially Jamaican. But her heritage is Jamaican. Don't you talk about Auntie Kamala? Don't you do it.
I like Jamaican accents.
Oh, okay. So that was just your way of paying homage to the Jamaican accent?
Of course.
Mm-hmm. Good way to do it. But yeah, so cold calling is something that you can definitely outsource if you don't want to do it.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool.
And she's very affordable too. She knock out about 150 calls a week, give it a script, give it a like the end result of what I want from the calls, give it the people off the list. And we like a marriage made in heaven at this point.
So where do you get the people for her to call from?
You can get lists anywhere.
Okay, y'all, that's a good tip.
That's what we're here for, baby.
That's a good tip. Let me write that down.
We're here to give y'all the game.
Outsource cold
call. Give y'all the game. We out here giving y'all these gems on 420, baby. Get at us.
So is it like the people who just call me randomly talking about, hey, we have healthcare plans for...
No, that's a robot. That's a robocall.
Okay, so...
Yeah, this is an actual person. I had to go through a couple of them, though, because you want to find the right one with the right accent. You don't want, you know, people can't... You don't want the people to get that feel of, oh, you soliciting me.
Okay.
It's just more of a conversation. And again, with cold calling, I think we get caught up with the rejection piece of it because we go into it thinking like our expectations are too high, right? So out of a list of 150 people, mm-hmm. right, you may get maybe 40 people. Like, first of all, you're not going to get everybody on the phone. Then you may get about 50, 60 people on the phone. And of those 50, 60 people, 15 of them going to be asked. They're going to be pissed off that you called. But then the other 30, they're going to be cool. Yeah. They're going to be all right. Because it's and out of that other 30, you probably going to get somebody that was like, you know what? Man, I'm glad you called me. Right? Like, somebody knocked on my door yesterday trying to sell me some solar panels. And okay. they little did they know, I was already considering solar panels. It was something I was looking into. I was about to go take a nap. It was disturbing my nap, so I was still already a little cranky. But when she said solar panels, I was like, you know what? It's something I've been looking into. Let her in. She gave me her little spiel. And look, she may have a new customer. I got to do a little more research, but she may have a customer.
I hear you get Call it for Matthew. Free with a grant.
But you know what? That need to be our next show because we need to talk about that. Because what I found out from my lady that came, her name was Dorian. Shout out Dorian. Dorian who gave me the game on that stuff, man. You lose some of your incentives when you go with the fee program instead of paying for them yourself. Aha. Hmm. Who knew? All right. I think it's that time, Jess. What we got? What do we got today? All right. Mary Kay Facial, sponsored by Margaret Harrison, one of our esteemed sponsors.
Get your face right.
There it is, virtual pampering.
Mm-hmm. Do it, girl. It's so much fun. It's so relaxing. Yep. And you get like a refresh for your face.
And you know, with Mother's Day coming up, you got some Mother's Day deals going on, right?
Yes, Mother's Day deals, Mother's Day boxes. They get all kind of nice little goodies. Mm-hmm. Y'all need to DM me because it's coming up. Don't let it sneak up on you and you ain't get your mother nothing.
Don't do that.
Don't let it sneak up on you.
Don't be that kid.
No.
And don't take care of your mom.
No.
You only get one mom.
Yes.
Take care of them.
Yes. All right, y'all. Let's see who the winner is.
Oh, I got a chance. I got a chance today. I got a chance today. Ooh, it's got to be me. Keisha J get the facial. She getting a facial today.
Good luck. But no, congratulations.
Yeah, it's over at this point. Yeah. She won already, Margaret.
Congratulations, Keisha.
All right. So what are we talking about next week?
Next week, we are
discussing. When should a rapper stop rapping?
When should rapper stop rapping?
What y'all think? When should a rapper give up rapping? Mm-hmm. Shout out to Too Short who came on to give, you know, shout out that 420 today. Hmm. But we ain't heard no Too Short song in a minute.
You know what? I have a clip for y'all for next week. Yes.
The juices are flowing.
Yes, I y'all have a clip tune for y'all.
In. And y'all then, better tune in.
And then we'll see how old is too old.
We'll see how old is too old. Be like tag team on the Geico commercials.
But they get money, though.
They get money.
Scoop, there it is. Scoop, there it is. They get money.
So I guess, hey, you just got to make it work. Absolutely. Oh, and then D-Nice. Have y'all heard D-Nice on the Ford commercials? Yeah, D-Nice.
Not her vanilla ice and iced tea on a commercial.
Yeah, no, that was Stone Cold Steve Austin.
All three of them.
Oh, okay.
All three of them.
Yeah, that was that Pandora commercial. But yeah, the D-Nice, they got that boy D-Nice on Ford, the reviving of D-Nice. My name is D-Nice, the D-Nice. That's the one they're playing too. Okay. My name is D-Nice, the D-Nice.
I can feel that too when you're in your car and it's bumping. Absolutely. Okay, that would make a good commercial.
All right, man. Well, look, another one in the books. Great being with y'all today on this beautiful Tuesday at 2:30. I am your host, Michael G. Davis, broker, CEO of Brooks & Davis Real Estate Firm, realtor plus business coach, a.k.a. Professor X, because I peel back them layers that's holding you back, stopping you from getting to the success that you want, right? That's why they call me that. And I'm joined, as always, with my girl to my right, Margaret.
Yes, I am Margaret, also known as Mystique, because I will flip on you. You're going to be wondering, where did that come from? She was nice.
Whoa.
But I get mean when it comes to negotiations.
Got to get the best deal for her client.
And we throw it over to Jess.
Finish yourself. Oh, cut that thing. It's your Keep It Real to a.k.a. J. Joseph, a.k.a. X-Ray, getting down to your real estate needs. I see what you can't see, you guys. We had a great show. Looking forward to the next one. And we're going to roll out. Shout out to one of our favorites, Luther Vandross on his day. Come on. Hey. It's never too much, guys. Luther Vandross, 70th birthday. Shout out to him and everybody who tuned in with us today. We will be back with Mastermind of Tough Times Tuesday at 2:30 next week. Come on, Gemma. Woo! Luther, rest in peace, my friend. We miss you, man. Hey, what you got there, Margaret? See you guys next week, guys. Just had to hear his voice a little bit. Take care.